Kovil Style Puliodharai. How Iyengar typically make a Puliodharai, that is what we are going to watch through this video. You got to experience that. I'm not sure how many of you have been to temples in Tamil Nadu and have tasted the real authentic Puliodharai there. It is really take you to a different world. That is the Puliodharai recipe that I am going to share it with all of you through this video. Please watch the video full. Hello everyone, welcome to Lathus Kitchen. All of you, if you are already visited here, thank you so much. If anyone is new, please do subscribe to us after watching this video. To begin with, how to make this Puliodharai, we need to roast the peanuts. Roast the peanuts in the right consistency without burning it and allow it to cool down in a separate plate and keep it aside. And we are going to make a Puliodharai powder, which is, take a pan, add 3 tablespoons of coriander seeds and a tablespoon of pepper, half a tablespoon of fenugreek seeds, tablespoons of sesame seeds, all that along. In fact, even we have to dry roast the red chilies, which we have to do it separately. So we are going to dry roast this spices. Meanwhile, you can peel off the skin from the roasted peanuts and keep it ready. Dry roast this spices along with the sesame seeds. Yes, also 4 to 5 red chilies depending on your spice intake. Dry roast and keep it aside. Dry roast, do not put it along with the spices. It might not roast properly. So do that separately and allow that to cool down. In the meanwhile, take a lemon sized tamarind, soak it in water. Squeeze it. Take out the pulp and fiber. Keep it ready. Now take a pan again. Must use sesame oil, no other oil, or at least you can use peanut oil, but no other oil. 3 to 4 tablespoons of sesame oil, a tablespoon of mustard seeds. Once the mustard seeds splatter, then 2 tablespoons of chana dal and a tablespoon of urad dal. You need to add quite a lot of oil if you are going to store it in a bottle. You are going to make it in a very large quantity. Curry leaves, of course, a bunch. Half a tablespoon of turmeric powder. But if you are going to make it little quantity, then you can use 2 to 3 tablespoons should be good enough. Once the dal is roasted, then add in the tamarind pulp. Squeeze out to take out the excess fiber using the strainer. Jaggery is a must for this recipe. Add a little bit of jaggery and the roasted peanuts. Now, this mixture, of course, more curry leaves. This mixture has to cook for 15 to 20 minutes on a slow flame. Also add salt and half a tablespoon of asafoetida, that is hing. Mix all well. Let the jaggery dissolve. Keep it in a slow flame. It has to cook in a slow flame for about 15 to 20 minutes. This mixture has to come down 1/4. It has to form a thick consistency. So we need not keep on stir at it. Just leave it. You may want to cover it or just leave it as it is. Let this cook for a good enough time. Then it will turn thick. In the meanwhile, make a powder of those dry roasted spices which we have made. This is the consistency of the powder I need for this Puliodharai. So now it is done 0.5%, but I need more thickness. The oil needs to start coming out. You can see that now almost done. Typically people add too much of an oil, but you know about me. But 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil is definitely good enough for the quantity of Puliodharai that I'm going to make. Now switch off the flame, add in the powder, just saute for 2 to 3 minutes. The spices are already dry roasted, it doesn't require too much of a cooking, so switch off the stove. The reason also why we switch off the stove then adding on this powder is so that it can retain all the flavor. Now it is thick, the right consistency that I wanted. Our Puliodharai paste is ready. At this stage you can add a lot of, maybe 2 to 3 tablespoons of oil and allow that to cool down, then store it. It will remain very fresh for 2 to 3 months also inside the fridge. This is the paste, and let me show you now how to make Puliodharai by adding the cooked rice onto it. I have kept little bit separate, which I'll be using it whenever I want by storing it in the fridge. Now adding on to the rice to the same pan which I have made this paste. The key is preferable use your hands, clean hands, to mix this. The more taste it is, the good mix the rice along with this paste. So possible, use your hands, clean hands, and mix it. And the second key is that it tastes very good if you serve this after 3 to 4 hours. Here you go, Puliodharai along with chips, a great combination. Or you can as well serve it with aloo roast. It tastes very good. Typically people who are traveling, this is the best food, who are rice lovers. You can add a lot of oil, but make this Puliodharai. And another key is, if you are making it for traveling, you need to allow the rice to cool down. If you have cooked the rice, then you need to mix it, otherwise it turns bad for the traveling. So do give it a try, friends. A typical authentic Kovil style Puliodharai, how typically Iyengars make. I'm sharing that recipe with you. I'm sure you're going to give it a try and you're going to let me know how it, you really liked it. I'm really looking forward to hear from you on how it turned out for you. Thank you so much for watching. Please do share this. It really means a lot. If you're new here, do not forget to subscribe to our channel. I will be coming up with more such authentic recipes. Thank you so much for watching.